When you combine fairy floss and macaroons, the result is just about the cutest dessert ever. And so joining us today to show us how to make the perfect macaroon is the gorgeous Daniela Boutros. Yay! Jess, I imagine that this is what the inside of you looks like.
Yes.
Fairy floss.
And unicorns.
Sprinkles and unicorns.
I look at this and I feel happy. Oh. I feel whole again.
Are they hard to make?
Oh. Do you know what? Like, yes, you need a few little tips and tricks, but once you've got them on board, it's fine. I mean, if we gave up on everything that was temperamental, I'd be single for the rest of my life. So, like, don't give up. Give it a go. Let's, like, try.
All right.
So you're going to whip up your egg whites.
Okay.
So until they're peaking.
You don't do it in a...
No, it'll take a while. Okay. So you can use your standalone mixer. Whip up your egg whites and they're peaking.
Then
you add in, well, six large ones. Okay. Six large. And the idea, the little trick behind your egg whites is you age your eggs.
Well, sorry, you age them?
You age your eggs. So it's better to use ones that are a little out of date. So it adds a bit of stretchiness to your meringue when you're whipping it up.
You won't make people sick, though.
No. Only a little.
A bit of stretchiness and the odd occasion salmonella.
Yeah. Only a little. By a few days, you'll be okay. And keep them out of the fridge the night before.
Oh,
okay, so you want to use some room temperature.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Okay, good tip.
So that'll be that. And then you just pop in your icing sugar.
Should I press this now?
Yep,
do this
go
now.
So caster sugar first.
Okay, this one?
That'll go in, yeah. And just start it on a low beat. Yeah, okay. So that one there. And that's going to keep going through. Now, while you're whipping that up, you can pop in, this is our mixture of almond meal and icing sugar. Ooh. And you just want to sift it all in together. So then it's nice and soft. And this is what you're going to fold in to your whipped meringue.
Could you use just normal flour? Or you need...
Macarons are for almond meal.
Okay.
Yeah, so they are.
Where do you get that at the supermarket? Almond meal?
Yeah, you can. Health food aisle, supermarket.
So it's health food.
Yeah.
This is even better.
It got exciting.
Now I'm busting. Can we make that higher?
Yeah. So that'll be fine now. All right. So you want to wait till your granules have mixed in nice and soft.
So it's not greasy.
Yeah, but you can always do a little test. So I'm always getting a little bit on and just rub it in till it's like hand cream.
Oh,
so it's nice and soft and you don't feel any sugar.
It's not
so
gritty.
You're all good.
Okay, yep. So take it off.
Yep, so just pop it up in. And then just scoop it into this bowl here. There we go.
Scoop it in. What should I use, darling? This one?
That's fine.
And when you say fold, I always wonder about this. How do you fold?
Yeah, so these are the tips that are going to help you make macaroons a lot easier. So you're just going to scoop it in.
Is it macaroon or macaron?
Macarons, but if you ask for macaroons, most people know what you're talking about.
I always call them macaroon.
Yeah, I don't think I'm not too precious about it, but
Sarah, I say maroon, not maroon.
Yes.
But potato, if I'm
potato,
on an island,
like, yeah,
exactly.
So that should be enough for now.
Okay.
And then you just want to fold it in. So do you want me to show you how
please.
To start?
Love that.
So you're not stirring, not mixing, not beating. It's just a light fold
gentle.
Over.
Gentle.
Oh. Nice and gentle. You don't want to lose all that
caress
lovely airiness in your batter. Do you want to give it a go?
Oh, is that what it's for? Okay, so keep the airiness there.
So you just softly until it's folding combined? It in until it's combined. So you're going to end up with this lovely mix that Jess has.
Right.
And another little trick about getting them perfectly shaped is on your baking tray. You're going to already mark out your circles.
Oh, I love this. And actually, you could get your kids to do the tracings.
Then they get involved.
Could you make them different shapes?
You could. Absolutely, you could. Yeah.
Great.
I can see love hearts coming out of Jess's kitchen right now.
Or cat shapes. So. You could get like a cat shape.
100%.
Do you want to do a cat now?
Can I?
Yes. Give it a
could
go.
I?
Yeah, give it a go. So you don't need this.
Oh.
Use that as your guide. Yeah, thanks, Sarah. So you want to go...
With the precision
that
of a
surgeon. That looks like a cat.
It looks like the cat's litter box.
I was going to say. You say it so much more eloquently.
There we go.
You can do that.
Mm.
That is, look at that.
Look.
There we go. We've got
you. Can you show us though how we would
could
do
you
it
do
properly?
A cat?
Yeah, neat one.
I'm not doing a cat. Just did a cat, no. So if you're going to pipe it on to get the round, you want to start in the middle, let it float out nice and softly.
See,
and I'm always using my other hand to steady my piping tip. There are little tricks like that I think
could
you need
I have
to
a
know.
Go?
Yeah. Oh, look,
I want to try
yes,
the
Jess.
Gently. So
and
that?
Then you're going to let it set on the baking tray for about 15 minutes till it forms a little bit of a crust.
Right.
And then you can always just use your finger to pat it down because you know how you want
to
get
it
nice
and
perfect.
You don't put it in the oven?
You do.
Oh, okay.
But you want it to set. Look at
that's
that.
That's not too
look
shabby.
Look at that. Good. From that great. To that. Very nice, Jess.
And what's this one?
So this is going into the oven, preheated, 150 degrees.
Really?
Fan, yeah, nice and light. Mm. And it's about 20 to 25 minutes. But know your oven. Everyone's oven is different.
Yep.
So just keep checking on it until they're hardened.
Mine's very different.
The fun part is when you first make it, maybe don't go too over the top, but once you get used to your bathtub.
Colours!
Yep, add colour. Add colour.
Just food colouring.
Yeah.
Wow.
So you can have good fun with that.
I love
so
that.
So these are nice, pretty colours. You can mix it up a bit like
how
that.
Pretty.
And then you've got filling.
I've got like baby trolls in here.
You go.
So if we're going to start decorating these bad boys, how would you do it? So you start off here.
Yeah, there's a few different things. Jess has coloured Fluoro Neo buttercream.
Wow.
So you can go in there. So hold your macaroon down.
But wow, I've never heard of something so magnificent.
You can go tall. Go for it, Jess. Just yep. And look at that.
Oh,
how fun is that? And then you can add little confectionery. Different fillings are fun. So if you like, you could put your buttercream on the outer side. Do a dollop of jam in the middle.
Fairy floss.
So when you bite it. Fairy floss, again, use your round cutter. Ooh. Cut into the fairy floss
fragile,
and you can have
it
nice and straight up like this.
How
you
gorgeous.
Can add some sprinkles on the side. And then how good is this idea? With the leftover fairy floss, you could make a fairy floss donut.
Wow. This looks amazing.
We don't believe in wastage.
It'd be great for, a hen's or a Mother's Day lunch or a baby shower.
And then
or
if you want to go
Sunday
a bit
breakfast. Danielle Burgess from Buttercream Lane. Oh, my goodness. We love
Anything golden sparkling.
Oh,
fine. Now, if you want to make your own macaroons, you can head to our website, template.com.au/studio10 to find the recipe. And as well, you can take a photo of your creation and post it on our Facebook
page.
Can
I just quickly say, look at that little baby unicorn.
Oh, these are great.
Look at this.
Can you see these?
Look at these. Like, how cute.
This is what Jess's dreams are made of, for sure.
Here it comes. Look, little eyes
look
and everything.
That.
Divine.
Could you take it any better?
Thank you.
And don't forget to use the hashtag Studio 10. Thank you so much, Danielle.
Thank you.